Beginnings of new projects are great. You're enthusiastic about the challenges that it will bring and ready to get to work. Your project backlog slowly gets filled with tasks and the team starts picking them up and making progress. But as you start working on your assignments, it's not uncommon for the backlog to keep growing instead of getting smaller. Whether this is a result of changing project directions, work being done wrong and reverting to the beginning, or of indecision from the stakeholders, as long as the list of things to do keeps growing, you will not see the project get finished, will you? What's more, a backlog that's always full can easily become irrelevant, causing project value drop and making completion seem unattainable. So what can you do then? Firstly, it would be a good idea to ensure that all people involved in the project have an understanding of what the backlog column represents. Is it a place for tasks that need doing? Is it where ideas for potential improvements get placed? Or is it an area in which work that was already done but needs redoing returns to? And if it's all the above, which tasks take the highest priority? Ensuring that everyone understands what your project backlog is and what it isn't, and adding structure to it, can increase chances of the project getting done in time. The simplest way to organize a backlog is by time frame. In many projects that evolve with each day and will inevitably deal with unplanned work, thinking ahead may only be possible for shorter lengths of time. With this structure, you can periodically review best next steps and rearrange the to-do list accordingly. Though not all projects will have a named product owner person, there is always someone holding power over all product decisions who therefore should keep tabs on what's in the backlog. It's important to regularly review which proposed tasks should make it to further process stages and which should be abandoned. Finally, it may be possible to limit the number of items allowed in the inventory based on the team's weekly capacity. Knowing that there are 6 people working every week, 30 hours each, gives you 180 hours to assign to planned tasks. So why not estimate each task in hours and limit this week's backlog by this maximum available number of hours? Now, after planned work reaches the maximum weekly capacity, any other items would be added with the awareness of them fitting outside the week's limit. And in order to easily point the team to which tasks need doing first, use the Kanban default approach with which topmost items are to be pulled first. You may also use built-in priorities or task colors to signify importance. Having the backlog items visualized alongside all process stages ensures that the involved parties stay informed of project status and have a live view of exactly what is being done. It makes it easier for the team to keep an eye on the big picture rather than just on the few tasks in front of them. And that's only the first benefit of using an online Kanban board. To learn what else there is to gain, start a free trial of the application at kanbantool.com.